Hello, Namaste and welcome. I'm Shikha Jain. At Inkpot Hub, we celebrate and enrich a researcher's journey by sharing their beautiful stories with you all. If you like the video, please like, comment and subscribe to our channel. Today's story is about an internationally acclaimed academician. She is vivacious, beautiful and extremely talented. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking about Dr. Rituparna Basu. Dr. Basu currently serves as Associate Professor and the Marketing Area Chair of IMI Kolkata. Dr. Basu completed her PhD in Management from IIT Kharagpur. She is also an alumnus of St. Xavier's College, Kolkata. Dr. Basu has received several prestigious global awards for her contribution to management, research and teaching. She has won coveted awards in the Emerald Case Writing Competition 2020, ISB Ivy Global Case Competition 2018 and 17. Her research accolades includes the AIMS Women Management Researcher Award 2017, Young Women Management Teacher Award in 2016. The list is very long. So let's welcome Dr. Rituparna. Thank you so much, Dr. Rituparna, for accepting our request.
Hi Shikha, that's very, very kind of you.
Dr. Rituparna, you are a researcher, a case writer, a beautiful singer and an amazing teacher. But our viewers want to know, who is Rituparna Basu?
Okay, a singing bit a lot of people don't know about, so maybe since you insist, I'll go back. I'm glad that you ask this question, because this gives me an opportunity to actually inspect and introspect on my journey that I have been in so far. Because when you're in a beautiful journey and so much of things are happening around you, you hardly get time to look out. I mean, think of what is the mode of transport, right? Or neither do you think about the destination. You're so enamored by what is happening outside the window. You're engrossed in the whole situation. You know, all the while, I have been a very, very passionate person when it comes to about learning. I have learned about anything and everything that I could get my hands on. In a nutshell, anything that involves thinking, anything that involves creativity, putting my own perspectives, interests me. I can recount back to my school days. During my school days, I was heavily into singing. I was learning Hindustani classical, and there wouldn't be any school function that I wouldn't be singing for. I was a child artist. I started off singing for All India Radio, and I started singing for Doordarshan at the age of 6. So I was heavily into singing. And so you might be thinking that, okay, if I was into singing, that how come I just got into studies? Yeah, because you have to understand the kind of environment that I was raised in. I was the only child born to a sportsman father, and my mother was into singing as well. In fact, at that point of time, she was also a radio singer. So my house, especially if you look at traditional Bengali families, the girls, you have to learn music, you have to be culturally oriented, you have to learn art. Sure. So that was something which came naturally to me, and I was doing that. And you know, at that point of time, I had a lot of interest in studies, because I used to like reading and writing. So as I said, I was always very, very interested in learning more. So at that point of time, studies was more like a co-curricular activity for me, which I was extremely passionate about. So even after my MBA days, MBA gold medal, I took up sales and marketing profiles in a media house, because I was into singing, I was into art, culture. So media, working for a media house was something which came naturally to me. But at the same point of time, I took to teaching because of the fact that I thought that if I'm teaching, I would be in touch with studies, which I liked doing. And as a result, I would read more. So there would be no kind of complacency. And by the virtue of good marks, I was also invited at guest faculties here and there while I was in my industry stint. Mm-hmm. And I was trying to find out ways in which I can learn more. So at that point of time, I came across this IIT advertisement, which was calling for PhD candidates. And thankfully, and by God's grace, I cracked the entrance. So at that point of time, I was preparing for the interview. I prepared for something around advertising effectiveness for media companies. Mm-hmm. And so there also, I did a small qualitative survey with the clients that I was handling. So when I actually faced the interview board, anything on everything that I was saying was coming from the experience that I had gained for all these 5 years. So it became all the more relatable. So I cracked it, and then began my journey at IIT, which actually opened a whole new idea of what career and academics can mean. Mm-hmm. And I was also part of the IIT contingent to University of Nebraska in Omaha, where we met the legendary Warren Buffett. And over there, we attended this workshop on international marketing, and that's when I heard these professors talk about different concepts, different frameworks, talk about research, when I really became extremely serious about research and academics as a career. By the way, at that point of time, back at IIT also, I had my music album. I had released my single music album, which was covered by not only media, Times of India and other Bengali dailies, but it was also carried by the IIT mag called Scholars Avenue, and they were like the star next door kind of. I was getting that kind of a treatment. But then suddenly it struck me that yes, though studies and academics was something more like a co-curricular passion that I had, but why not? I became a little more serious about studies and research, because that itself became very, very motivating, that every day I could learn something new. So if you talk about case writing, because you mentioned case writing, case writing came in a lot later. After my PhD, when I joined full-time academics in 2013, so after that I was teaching. I was trying to prepare for my classes. I wanted to get more and more effective with my classes. So mm-hmm. I was reading up a whole lot of cases. At that point of time, my institute also sent me to attend this case writing workshop, which was conducted by IEB. And there also I got some very, very interesting ideas and insights on how to write cases. So I came back and I was again doing a lot of cases in the class. And then I realized that, you know, since I have some industry knowledge, why don't I bring them to class? So that was the time I sincerely thought that maybe I should write cases on industries that I'm extremely familiar with. And that's when case writing started. So both the journeys started very differently, but it was extremely, extremely situation driven. So if you want me to summarize my journey into academics, I would call it a journey from jingles to journals.
Amazing.
And I have been jingling all my way through and enjoying it every day.
This is so beautiful. So, Rituparna, how does it feel when you are globally recognized? You get an honorable mention by, you know, Ivy, and you're getting the awards back to back. What is your experience? How does it feel?
Yeah, Shikha, I have been very, very fortunate that I have been writing cases for a little more than 3 years now. Mm-hmm. And I have four global awards and very, very prestigious global awards. In fact, 2018 was a very, very special year because the year before that, 2017, I won the ISB IB Global Case Competition, the overall competition,
okay,
with a case on a company which is based out of Calcutta. It's into luggage and lifestyle kind of company. In fact, the company where the case was set is very close to my office. So I used to go and visit their shop floor, and I used to have a very, very direct contact with the protagonist. So that was the first case. But it came in as a surprise. It came in as a big motivation. And then I thought that, okay, in the next year, in the next edition, let me write two cases. Okay. Why? Because any kind of submissions to a competition would require you to work on a tight deadline. And that way, I'll be extremely, extremely sure that I'm going to finish the work and the output. So I collaborated with my co-author, mm-hmm. and we started writing two cases to be sent to the journal. It was not about winning, because winning is never on your mind. You always, if you ask me, I would always like to write a good case that enthuses a whole lot of lively interactions in the class. So that's the whole objective. So the whole idea was, by 2018, if we are having some entries into the case competition, let me just try with two cases. And that's what I planned. And we finished the two cases and sent it off. And that year, very, very surprisingly, both the cases made it to the winners list.
Wow.
One won the, it didn't win the overall competition, but one won the marketing category title, and one was the honorable mention, got the honorable mention title out of the 10, top 10 cases.
Wow.
So that was a very special year, and it gave me a whole lot of conviction that the kind of output that we were producing was really, really one of the best to be recognized in such global platforms. And this year, again, we won the Seaman Emerald Case Writing Competition with the runners-up title. Thank you very much. So, winning is never a destination. Winning is just a reward for all the hard work. And of course, it's a great feeling, Shikha. It's always a great feeling to win. Because the moment you win, you're like, okay, what next? You're actually getting up on your shoes and you're thinking, okay, what next? That's great. And it's such an encouragement.
So how do you choose these companies to write cases?
Shikha, that's very, very interesting. I never choose my protagonist, because I feel that the case writer should be someone who is absolutely, absolutely unbiased. Mm-hmm. Now, when it comes to choosing a company, I generally choose companies from industries that I'm extremely familiar with.
Okay.
Because familiarity with the industry is a very, very important predeterminant or prerequisite to writing a good case. Mm-hmm. If the case writer is not familiar, he or she will not be asking the right kind of questions to the protagonist. He or she will not have an idea about what is going on. So that kind of familiarity is important.
Sure.
So when I took to case writing, I was actually starting off writing media industry cases, because I was extremely familiar with that industry, because I have worked in that industry.
Okay.
So when it comes to any kind of jargons, any kind of colloquial terms, I can relate to it. I know exactly what that person needs.
Mm-hmm.
So suppose you want to write a branding case. I would like to bring those company examples to my branding class and try and see whether the students are going to relate to it.
Mm-hmm.
When I see a lot of positive indications that the students are able to relate to the idea, they're getting enthused, mm-hmm. they're getting very energetic in terms of discussing about those companies. This is absolutely in the pre-planning stage. Then I would go ahead and finalize, okay, I would like to write on this company. And the next step is, again, very, very crucial. Get in touch with the company and see whether they would like you to write a case on them or not, because that is extremely, extremely important.
As you said, awards are not the main aim, but they do inspire. So what else inspires you to keep going and keep doing so much of work and make your work recognized in this research space?
See, I am equally passionate about case writing, and I'm equally serious about, writing good research articles. Mm-hmm. Though I have a long way to go, but when it comes to inspiration, I think when it comes to case writing, the inspiration I draw from the class. So when you're taking a case to the class, you see the students getting excited about the case, they are discussing. That itself is very, very encouraging. I feel that when you have written a case and you're bringing it to the class, mm-hmm. you directly influence or you directly generate a different level of passion or different level of involvement, mm-hmm. In the class. Mm-hmm. So that itself is a great inspiration for you to write cases, because, when you're good at writing cases and once you have that feeling of teaching your own case in the class, you would like to have more cases which you can teach to your students. That itself is very, very inspiring. Moreover, the students are always like wide-eyed, ma'am, you had written this, so let's discuss this case. You can actually move out of the boundary of the case at times. That makes it very, very lively in terms of the discussion board, and becomes very interesting. When it comes to journals or articles, I get inspired by all the stalwarts who are working in their field. It wouldn't be right to name a few, but if you insist, I can say I follow Steenkamp's work, I follow Moorman's work, I really like Batra, Grewal, their work. There are some of my contemporary researchers who are doing extremely well. They are going extremely aggressive with their publication career. I also follow their work a lot. So they are very, very inspiring. And back at home, my son is always inspiring me. He's always asking me, Ma, what are you writing? So that's also an inspiration. So he's always wide-eyed. So he doesn't understand the difference between a case, when I'm writing a case, mm-hmm. or whether I'm writing a journal article. He thinks that Ma is writing. So he doesn't understand. So he's like, okay, is this secondary? Is this primary? So he has picked up some of the journals, jargons, and he keeps using them. That itself is very, very inspiring. So he's always like, Ma, you are not writing for some time. What happened, Ma? Are you busy with your classes? You're not writing. So he knows. So that itself is also very inspiring.
Your son is your on the spot feedback and your motivator.
Yes, you would be surprised to know at times. Suppose I'm sending something to Emerald, or I'm sending something to, a Taylor and Francis. So he'll come and suddenly he'll peep and he'll see, Ma, but they want UK English. You must change your default setting. So he understands a little bit. He's 11, he's in class 6.
My goodness. So he's on your footsteps. Yeah.
I don't know. I'm sure he wants to be a cricketer. Definitely not following my footsteps, but he keeps a close watch on my footsteps.
Oh wow, amazing. So, Dr. Rituparna, a lot of young scholars aspire to be like you. They want to become a star researcher or a case writer like you. So what is mm-hmm. it that you want to, what is that message you want to give?
First and foremost, I would like to say that believe in yourself, work hard, and never stop learning. Love what you do. That is extremely, extremely important. Follow your heart. There's actually so much happening in the research sphere now. It's getting very, very competitive. Journal writing, journal article writing, and case writing are very, very different from each other.
True.
A lot of young scholars come to me after I have got a little bit of publicity with all these 4 awards that I have bagged. A lot of them come up to me and say that, ma'am, I want to write a case. Do you think I can write a case? My only suggestion to young writers is you need to have good amount of familiarity with the industry, before you start writing a case. Mm-hmm. And the second one is, the best cases are the ones whose teaching note is very, very good. You need to have a very, very strong teaching note to make it into a strong case. Mm-hmm. So in order to write a teaching note, it might be a bigger challenge for young researchers because they wouldn't have that kind of experience in the class in terms of handling students. A good, sharp teaching note requires a person who is writing it to have a lot of in-class experience. So that is very, very important. So a great idea. It's never too late to start, never too early to start. But if you really want to start writing case study, get familiar with an industry that you would like to write on. And secondly, if you are not having too much of teaching experience, always try and collaborate with someone who, I mean, a more matured case writer who would have greater amount of industry familiarity and a rich teaching experience to learn from. I think that's the way to be.
Okay. Thank you so much, Dr. Rituparna, for talking to us. Your journey from jingles to journals had been very, very inspiring, and I'm sure our viewers are going to love it.
And never miss another update.